All right, and we're back again. More Mass Effect. All right.
Just take a deep breath. I still can't believe Dad's dead. This should have been his moment.
But now it's yours. You just need to decide what you're going to do with it.
Where do I start? I'm just not sure I'm ready.
We weren't ready to fall out of the sky on Habitat 7. But we survived that.
I just updated the charts.
Right. So, always keep a jump jet handy.
Yep. Back with more. I know I've been through this already, but it's alright. I may do, like, some side missions, like, off the recording.
It'll be nice to see some maybe faces this time.
But I know for a fact, like, while I'm uploading this to YouTube, I do want to, like, dedicate most of my time to playing this game.
They built a bar, right? Gotta have champagne for the welcome party.
You're expecting one?
What?
After what we've been through, I could use a buzz.
We all could.
Yeah. Rough ride so far.
We'll bounce back. Real food and a shower are just ahead.
Not even what time is it? It's like 3:40 in the morning. Like, I know I'm gonna go to sleep soon. I always do these recordings at like 4 o'clock in the morning. It's the only time I get some peace.
Where is everybody?
Can you tell us where the welcome party is hiding?
I'm sorry. My code is limited to information and simple interaction simulation. Please select from the following pre-programmed responses.
What year is it?
The current year is 2819. After spending over 600 years in stasis, it's normal to feel disoriented or confused upon arrival. Our helpful medical staff can assist with any physical or psychological after effects you may be experiencing.
Well, she's got the date right, at least.
So where is everyone? What can you tell me about the Andromeda Galaxy?
Here in Andromeda, you are over 2 million light years away from the Milky Way Galaxy. This is the furthest any life form has ever traveled outside our home system, making you a brave pioneer indeed. The Nexus itself is located in a region known as the Helios Cluster. Here, you and thousands of your fellow colonists will fulfill your dreams of settling a new home. Fortune awaits.
That's all.
It has been my pleasure. Please see one of our helpful immigration staff for further assistance. And welcome to your new home in Andromeda, where the brightest star is you. Current wait time for immigration processing is... unknown error.
Right. That was helpful.
Well, this can't be right.
It's like everything's on standby.
If it's a surprise party, they're doing an awfully good job of it.
Plants are still alive.
They didn't finish building it.
Hi there. We're from Ark Hyperion, and wondering where everybody went.
Did he hear you?
Did you say an Ark? Yeah, we just got in.
And for what it's worth, your VI over there could use an update.
But we thought you were all dead.
What?
Or captured, or lost in dark space, or...
But you're here. You have no idea how much this means.
I don't believe it. I'm Tyrann Kendrys. I lead our militia on the Nexus.
I'm Ryder. This is Cora Harper and Liam Costa, part of the Pathfinder team.
I'm sorry for the confusion. Our sensors told us an Ark had arrived, but Helios is notorious for scrambling equipment. We thought you were just another malfunction.
But
Aren't you expecting us?
You're the first Ark we've seen. After a year of waiting and no sign of the others, we shuttered this area and stopped looking.
You've been stranded for a whole year?
Longer. I'll fill you in on the way to Op Center. Everything that could go wrong with our plan has. We arrived 14 months ago. Right away, we hit a band of dark energy that knocked us off course.
We're familiar with it.
Then you'll know why we call it the Scourge. We lost whole sections of the station. A lot of people died. No power, no food. The chaos went on for months. It finally led to armed rebellion. When order was restored, the insurgents were banished. Exiles, we called them.
Are things back to normal?
Not even close. But you're here now, so maybe the worst is over.
No word from the other Pathfinders?
No word from anyone, period.
Any threats from the locals?
So far, we've stayed hidden. We're in no shape to deal with an attack.
We had a first contact situation on Habitat 7. Whole thing went south. They tried to kill us.
That wasn't first contact. We know about them. Those aliens are going to be a real problem.
This day just keeps getting better.
We're here.
You guys go ahead. I'll check out the security situation.
You should know our command structure has been fractured. Some of us are filling in for leaders who died.
Is it true?
They said drop everything and report for duty.
And no one was expecting an Ark to finally show up.
Docking procedures are green across the board.
Stand by to merge Hyperion power into the grid.
The crew of the Hyperion.
Good luck.
I'm Jaren Tan, director of the Initiative. You have no idea how much your arrival means to us.
We've heard about what happened, and we're ready to help.
We could use any supplies you have. Food, water, we're short on everything.
This is Foster Addison. She oversees colonial affairs. Where's the Pathfinder?
You're looking at him.
You're not Alec Ryder.
My father's dead. He made me his successor.
Alec is dead. Please understand, the entire initiative is at risk. None of the Golden Worlds panned out. They're a bust, and there's been no word from the other arms.
What happened to them?
Unknown. Our supplies are nearly depleted. Rationing bought us some time, but even that's running out.
We need to find more resources, but that takes people, and we can't wake them up.
Until they have somewhere to live. A golden world.
Now more than ever, we need a Pathfinder.
It now falls to you, Ryder. Are you up to the task?
My father believed I am. If you trusted him with a job, you'll have to trust his judgment.
Your father won't be around to fix things if you fail.
That's no way to treat a guest. I'm Nakmor Kesh, superintendent of this station. Hope they haven't scared you off already.
It's nothing personal, but now isn't the time for on-the-job training.
At least the Pathfinder here seems willing to try. We could use a fresh perspective.
You've heard my concerns. I'll leave you to it.
We're all feeling the pressure. Let's have a private word in my office, Ryder. We'll discuss giving you a scoutship. I'm happy to work out the details with your associate.
Welcome to the Nexus.
I can't believe how far off track things have gone.
It's bad, but it's not over. Not yet.
Ma'am, the Hyperion's core is now online.
Let me show you something. An hour ago, that was all dark. But with the power from your ship, you're keeping the lights on. You have my vote.
And when the power runs out?
You'd best go talk to Director Tan. make sure that doesn't happen. And don't be shy. Come see me when you have a chance.
Ray. Now, I have to talk to the world. You have received an objective, Yana.
This is the planet where we landed, Habitat 7. It wasn't even close to livable.
That's been true of every world we found. Ryder, we were discussing your next expedition.
I thought it didn't measure up as Pathfinder.
Director Addison keeps her own counsel. I keep mine.
And when you disagree?
I oversee the entire initiative, and I have decided to give you a chance to prove yourself. To that end, the Scourge dealt us a serious blow. Whatever it is, our scientists theorize it's not natural.
An artificial energy cloud?
It wasn't here when we left the Milky Way, yet it rendered all the Golden Worlds unlivable. Then there's the aliens you ran into, the Ket. They're obsessed with alien structures we found scattered around the cluster. They'll do anything to prevent others from accessing them. It seems murder isn't exclusive to the Milky Way. And now the challenge is to settle a world in spite of all that. This one here. Eos.
How?
You need to increase the viability of the planet so we can establish an outpost. Then we can bring more colonists out of stasis. The more colonists we have, the more resources we can gather to support the Nexus. Everything depends on it. There are 6 worlds we hope to settle.
Okay, but you said every planet you found is unlivable. So, how do I...
A good Pathfinder would relish the challenge of solving it.
Right. I think I should go check on things.
And if I fail, I guess it's no sweat off your back, right? You'll just look for another Pathfinder?
Placing bets on people is part of my job. Some of them pay off. Others...
Just point me to my ship and I'll be out of here.
They're prepping it now in the docking bay. The coordinates for Eos will be in the computer. And when you have a moment, we should discuss the missing arcs.
I was wondering about that. Ah.
Something wrong?
Ryder, please see me and Samnode on the Hyperion. Your implant needs attention, and we need to discuss a confidential matter.
No, I'm fine.
All right. Gotta get those viability points. Holy shit!
Hey, you okay?
I'm fine. My arm's got the brunt of it.
Stuff exploding like this happen often?
Back right after the mutiny, we had a lot of this happening. But not lately.
I wasn't there during the mutiny.
Lucky. I thought we were done with this, honestly. That maybe I was just being paranoid.
What is there to be paranoid about?
We've had 3 malfunctions in the past week.
That's not good. Sorry, understatement.
Yeah. And now I have more repairs.
Did you talk to security about this?
How can I? For all I know, someone in security is the one doing this. I've scanned all the potential sabotage areas I can think of. But I don't know who to trust anymore.
Sounds like a lot went down before the Hyperion docked.
Yeah, I guess. Wait. That's it. You can't possibly be involved in this. You weren't even here during the mutiny. Would you, if you have time? Maybe you could help me. If they start hitting critical systems.
Sure thing. What can I do?
If you could scan these other panels while I fix this one, that'd really help. I've sent the locations to your Omnitool. Just send me the data when you're done.
Nah, I wish I wasn't getting throttled so much. I'd live stream more. I think I'll have to stop streaming, like, as much. Because every stream I do, like, I drop 10% of the frames on there because of the internet. Not even because of the computer now. Just constantly getting throttled every day. It's not fun. Discovered a new location. There's another side quest over here. Talk to the man Condoros.
adventure year, did they?
Something like that?
You get used to it. Just focus on being a Pathfinder. Can't argue with results. Though they'll try. Anyway, welcome to Militia HQ. Excuse the mess. This office fields militia work, Nexus security, and looking for the Turian Ark.
What's the word on the Turian Ark?
Scattered readings. Some indicate the Natanis was destroyed, others that people are alive. Who knows? If you need anything, come see me, even if it's just a vent.
You talk like you weren't part of the leadership. How did you end up commanding the militia?
I was escorting a prospecting team on some moon when those Ket found us. They penned us like cattle for experiments. I managed to get loose, snatched a gun, and freed the others. By the time we killed the bastards and headed back to warn the Nexus, everyone looked at me like I was in charge.
That sounds familiar.
The militia grew from there. Funny, once the heat is on, all kinds of people rise to the top.
And I know about all of this stuff, too.
Bye, Kandros. Duty calls.
You and me both, Pathfinder.
And that was my, thing going off.
It's not right. It's not fair.
What's wrong?
Oh my, you're... So it's true. A Pathfinder has found us. There's hope at last. Maybe you could help. You're impartial. This whole thing has gotten so political. My husband, he's locked up and slated for exile for a crime he didn't commit.
What exactly was he convicted of?
They don't exile you for petty theft. Well, maybe this bunch would. They say it's murder. They're calling him the first murderer in Andromeda. But the dead man was his friend. He wouldn't have. There are witnesses and evidence, but it's all circumstantial. At worst, it was an accident. His name is Milken Rensis. He could give you the details if you were willing to speak with him. Please.
I'd be happy to.
Oh, thank you. I'm sure the jailer will allow you a visit. Please, tell Milken I love him.
The first murderer in Andromeda. I still need to speak with Sam on the Hyperion.
There you are. Hope the others haven't been giving you a hard time. There's a lot that needs doing. At least with the Hyperion hooked up and feeding us power, my team and I can get more work done. What sort of problems have you seen on the Nexus?
Situations gone to shit pretty much sums it up. There's arcs missing. Some idiots tried to mutiny and take over, then more idiots offended my clan, so they left. And to top it all off, the founder of the Initiative, Gian Garson, was killed.
I notice there aren't a lot of Krogan around.
You haven't spoken to Number 8 yet, have you?
Number 8?
Tan. Ask him why most of my people left. He'll have opinions. I can tell you this much. When the mutiny happened, a deal was made. My clan were supposed to settle matters and, in return, get more say in the Initiative.
Why do you call Tan 8?
Because he was 8th in line to take over the Andromeda Initiative. I like to remind him of that now and then. Keep him humble.
Did the deal go through?
The clan held up their part, but Tan had a meltdown when he found out we wanted more say around here. Then Addison's assistant, Spender, pretended he never made the deal in the first place. It was a mess, but I don't blame my people for walking out. We're done being used.
With your clan gone, why did you stay?
It's complicated. The station and my clan both need me here.
Alright.
Nothing more for now. Later.
Won't be 100% in-depth one. At least not now, because I did all this stuff already. And for the sake... I'm just steal this shit right here. And just for the sake of not putting so much time on the video, I'll leave it at that.
Coon and your goddamn father. Sorry, my face is tired from dealing with everything. And right now, I just want to know what happened with Alec.
I don't want to get into it. Things went wrong. And now I'm the one you have to deal with.
Alec Ryder wouldn't accept that kind of ultimatum. Damned if I were. We'd never have left home if we... Not home. The Milky Way. This is home. This mess. We don't have a lot of options, Ryder. Maybe you'll prove your father right. After 14 months of failed colonization, forgive me if I don't hold my breath.
You've had no colony successes in over a year. How many tries is that?
Less than you'd think. The Scourge, spoiled worlds, exiles, hostiles. We can't just plop down an outpost and expect picket fences. We need the Pathfinder and Sam to scout, evaluate, and inspire. The initiative promised a goal. Andromeda has not cooperated.
And if it had?
Beautiful utopian horseshit. Colonies that produce and support each other. The Nexus as Citadel, not headed by Tan, or even me.
There must be some kind of plan for encountering hostile aliens. We can't have been that naive.
We expected life, not an enemy that refuses to talk. They don't attack, they disinfect. We're nothing until we're bacteria. Sorry, 14 months and you stoop to poetry. That's how bad it is. Talk to Kandros if you haven't. He's unfortunately become the head of our military. And as soon as he realizes it, we're in the shit.
You don't trust him?
I trust him to defend us. I do not trust a rising military influence in a supposedly civilian initiative. We came here to make history, Ryder. Not repeat it. Ugh, goddamn poetry.
You called my father Alec. No one does that.
A lot of us joined the initiative because of his vision. What he shared of it, anyway.
Were you friends? Or...
I'm not your new mother, if that's what you're asking. Or his friend. He hated that I didn't use his title. But no one's a Pathfinder until they've path-found something.
She makes a good point.
Much like a colonial director without colonies.
How do you fit into the Nexus leadership?
I oversee the actual settlement effort. As the number of outposts is currently less than ideal, my influence is limited. As Tan is quick to remind me. Left a perfectly adequate career as a chief officer. Provincial capital, too. Only a new galaxy could pull me away. And here we are, idling.
There's also the strange technology. Has anyone studied that?
We've tried. Not me. The brains in research. They're supposed to know their business. The current excuse? The tech we dug up on Mars was more advanced, but it was plug and go. The tech here thinks different? I don't know. We've mostly avoided it. And from what the Hyperion logs say about Alec, maybe that's good.
Excuse me, Director Addison.
Ryder?
It's Pathfinder.
Ryder, we're starving here. If we don't get a foundation of outposts to feed the initiative, we might as well be 600 years dead. Alec promised a lot. None of it panned out. That's what you're up against. Why people won't trust you. Why I don't trust you. Prove me wrong.
That reminds me of that Dave Chappelle bit where that one transsexual he knew, like, put his fake dick on the table, just slapped it on the table, just, let's talk business, gentlemen. Yeah, that's what that reminds me of right there. Alright. Oh, that's right, I totally did level up, but I'll worry about that sometime in the future. That's priority ops. That's missing arcs. A lot of additional tasks. I'm going to do this one, getting to know the Nexus. Speak with Tan. I gotta speak with Tan again? Christ, help me. It's all good. It's all good, boys. Where the hell you think you're going?
You must be the Pathfinder. Wonderful. You and your Sam are exactly what we need.
Thanks, Mr.
Professor Herrick. My colleagues and I will work with your Sam and the data you gather to solve Andromeda's scientific mysteries.
What fields do you study?
Herrick's in the life sciences.
I do planetary geology, oceanography, rocks and runoff. Aradana's the space and math ways.
Not that we've had much to study, with everyone cooped up for 14 months.
But your data on the Scourge flows like poetry. Now we can better advise on repairing the damage it caused.
And maybe Addison will give us a real workspace. Who can think with all this racket?
Good point. Good point. Yeah, that's right. You walk away from me. Alright. Now to talk to Tan again. I seriously don't want to do that absolute completionist run, though. Like, getting every single piece of information there is to get.
Ryder, you have my condolences for your father.
I appreciate it.
I didn't know him very well, although I understand he played a key role in planning the initiative. I'm sure he'd be concerned that we still have several arcs missing.
Any idea where they went?
Nothing certain. But tens of thousands of colonists are unaccounted for. It paints the initiative in an unflattering light. Did you have some other business?
Any more information you can give me on the missing arcs?
No, and that is the distressing part. The Asari, Turian, and Salarian arcs are completely unaccounted for. If they had the same problems with the Scourge that we did, I fear the worst. Should you find any clues, please investigate. Without the other arcs, the promise of the initiative can never be fulfilled.
Are there any other arcs we should expect?
We had hoped Quarians would be part of the first wave, but before departure in 2185, we got word they had technical problems with their ship. It seems they're also bringing along Drell, Hanar, and other species as well. Managing all of their biological needs caused complications. We won't see them for some time to come.
But I know about everything else.
That's all. Thanks for your time.
I'm happy to help. You will find our futures depend on each other's success. Good luck.
Mission complete. I'm going to level up some. I'm gonna go into biotics. Yeah, throw. It's definitely an ability I want. These sniper rifle mods I got.
Pathfinder, to cover their tracks, the saboteur is overloading power to this panel from another junction relay. You can scan and trace the connective wiring to locate the surrogate panel. Trace the wiring to locate the panel that the saboteur used.
did scan that, right? I know I totally did. Yeah, I know I totally did. Alright, let me go back up here then. I know I'm still new to this whole Let's Play thing. But at least, like, with Let's Plays, at least you guys get to talk to me, you know? Oh, there it is. Not like I'm being someone else or anything.
Scanning power junction relays. This panel is malfunctioning. Without more data, I cannot determine if this is a normal malfunction or sabotage.
I'll just disable power to the panel until Raj can check it out.
I gotta go all the way upstairs. I mean, unlike my guide videos or anything like that, you know, my goal is to guide, but, you know, when I'm playing through this...
Pathfinder, I received the data from Sam. It really is sabotage.
Any idea as to who it might be?
Yeah. All these panels were worked on by Zara. I just can't believe it.
Security video logs confirm that Zara Kellis worked on these panels, as well as the one Raj Patil encountered.
Well, shit. Any idea where she is now?
Kellis is currently working on a panel on the Hyperion main deck.
Now, like, what I mean is, it's like, there's a different vibe to me when I make my guide videos, or whenever, like, I'm doing a live stream or anything like that. You know, this is just me chilling in my room at 4 o'clock in the morning playing video games, you know, before I go to sleep. I've always had like a calmer demeanor than most, but at least here it's just like you can just see it in full force. Like, I wouldn't say completely unedited and not completely raw either. It's just, you know, I think it will help people, you know, realize just who I am, or a better sense of who I am.
Zara Kellis?
Yes.
I have evidence you've been sabotaging the Nexus.
What? No, I'd never... I've been looking into this myself. I have the scans to prove it. Here, I'll transfer the scans I took to your Omnitool.
Funny. Raj was investigating the same thing, and it led us to you.
My scans point at Raj as the one. So unless someone was setting us both up, I just don't understand.
The data Miss Kellis has accumulated is strangely similar to Mr. Patel's. A third party seems likely.
Looks like someone is using both you and Raj to cover their tracks.
They need pretty high level access for that. Still, it's better than thinking Raj could have done this. But it means all the data I have is useless. Wish I had access to the security cams. I bet we could find something there.
You stay put, so whoever did this doesn't realize we're onto them. I'll check out the security cams. Raj, you there?
Yes. How did it go? Is it really her?
Wasn't her. She had proof pointing at you. I figure someone's been messing with you both. Just keep a low profile and don't talk to anyone. I'm on it.
Now it's just the whole like live thing. I don't think I'm very good at yet. You know? Also, at the time of this video, I did recently turn 25, so, you know, hooray about that. But I think, like, videos like this are just, like, meant to be watched, like, whenever you're just chilling out or something. Just, like, to kick back and watch, you know? Like, I know I'm calmer, but honestly, I think that's just my introvertedness just coming in. Because even then, like, I'm going, like, way out of my element here, if I'm speaking honestly. Like, I'm not really one to be speaking like this and then, like, to do a Let's Play video. I gotta constantly be talking, and that's not something I always did.
This file is useless. Let's check another. And another screen.
Let's check another. This file is also corrupted. Definitely not a coincidence. You'd need pretty high clearance to mess with the security camera files. Someone working for Kandros, maybe.
That is the most probable scenario.
Think you can get enough out of the files to find a match using biometric scans, Sam?
The files were badly scrambled, but if I combine all the available identifiers, it might work. Based on the limited information available, we are looking for a human male, assigned either to the Nexus or Hyperion. You will need to conduct scans from close proximity.
Got it.
Biometrics do not match.
Like, I try my best not to be quiet during these videos, but whenever I'm like really into the game, let me talk to Cora real quick.
Hey there.
You okay? Those guys really grilled you. And Addison, first Pathfinder they've seen in over a year. All she can do is question your competence.
She understands the stakes. If I fail,
you won't.
Let's hope not.
You won't. That's the end of it. I worked out logistics with Director Tan. They're giving us a ship and crew. He said their best is taking care of it.
I still need to head back to the Ark and check in with Sam.
Sounds good. While you're there, maybe see how your sister's doing.
Yeah, anyway. Yeah, like, I'm still... I don't know when this video will be out. But even then... It's just, I know I'm still, like, really new to this. I do want to get better at it.
Biometrics do not match. Scan results show a partial positive. Target is most likely suspect.
Dale Atkins, right? We need to talk.
Look, not to be rude, but I have work to do.
Is that what sabotage is called these days? Work?
You're pretty arrogant for the new kid. You don't even know what's been going on.
Proof says you've been up to no good.
Figures. Screw this. Screw all you hypocrites on this station. You weren't here when they kicked out our loved ones. Mutiny? We just wanted answers. My sister is out there. I don't even know if she's alive or...
Whatever happened back then, hurting people now makes no sense.
What do you know? I don't care what you think. The mutiny leaders were right to demand to know what was going on.
You could have hurt people, killed them.
Like those who got killed when the leadership had the Krogan stomp on my friends? I'm done talking. I confess, it was me. Do whatever you want.
Not my call. The Nexus leaders will make that decision.
That lot make a decision. That'll be the day.
So then he just like walks away. But hey, viability points. Alright. Not a total loss. Alright, what's next? Time to do the first murder. I think maybe after I do the first murder, I'll probably call it for this particular video. Probably try to get another one done in the meantime, or rather in my free time. Cause I know my sleeping medication is like starting to kick in now. Woohoo! We gotta talk to a fucking murderer, man.
Help you?
Pathfinder Ryder, here to see Nilkin Rensis.
Ah, our murderer. Wife's here all the time. Guess she told you her sob story. Nilkin, you're moving up in the world. There's a Pathfinder wanted to chat with you.
The Pathfinder, huh? They called in the big guns to exile Andromeda's first murderer.
I'm not here to exile you. I told your wife I'd look into things.
At this point, it's too late. They found me guilty.
Why don't you tell me what happened?
I was part of the futile effort to set up a colony on Eos. We were on our last legs, overrun by hostiles, our leader dead. The security chief, Reynolds, my friend, he refused to call for evacuation. I argued with him. Everyone saw.
So when he was killed, people assumed you did it?
For good reason. He ordered us to regroup and counterattack. We were moving through a sandstorm. I saw movement, thought it was the Ket, and I guess I panicked and fired. Witness saw the chief's chest explode.
Sounds like an accident.
That's what I told them. But I was enraged when we argued. There's a recording. It's ugly. Everyone's certain I did it on purpose so we could evacuate. Only my word otherwise.
I'll check out the evidence. Maybe something doesn't add up.
It'd be nice to have someone with an open mind looking at it. You're a Pathfinder. I'm sure Kandros would give you access. Maybe there's still hope.
Speak with Kandros!
No news on the Turian Ark yet. Or is this militia business?
I spoke with Nilkin Rensis, the man found guilty of the murder on Eos.
Yes, our first murder here in Andromeda. I wish it had been our last. When the colony attempts failed, it didn't help spirits that a high-ranking officer was killed by one of our own. The mutiny here on Nexus was probably inevitable, but this acted as a spark.
So there was a trial, and he was found guilty?
It was short and decisive. Despite the lack of physical evidence, everything added up. His only defense was, trust me, I didn't mean to do it.
And you assume he's lying?
What's a lie to a murderer? Look, knock yourself out. A key witness, Cassidy Shaw, works in operations. Go ahead and talk to her. And there's a recording of the perpetrator threatening the victim. I'll let you cue it up on the console there. As far as I'm concerned, this case is closed.
Bye, Kandros. Duty calls.
You and me both, Pathfinder.
Have the option to do that. Oh, right here.
The Nexus versus Colonist. Looking evidence 7A.
Ira! They seized the compound! Call for evacuation!
We're not giving up, Nilkin. We're taking it back!
No! I'm not letting your ego get us killed! Even if I have to... No! Get him off me! Get him off me!
Speak with Witness Shaw, baby.
Cassidy Shaw? I'm Ryder. I'm looking into the Nilkin murder case.
Oh man, I thought that was over with. Have you heard the audio recording of their fight?
Yes.
I helped pull him off Chief Reynolds. You could see it in his eyes. He was gonna kill him. Then in the sandstorm, I had a pretty clear view of the chief. He looked right at Nilkin and shouted, no. Then his chest burst open. I'll never forget it. The look on his face was pure shock.
Reynolds was leading you back to retake the compound. Did you agree with that?
It wasn't my place to agree or disagree. He was ranking officer. In retrospect, it is ironic. If he hadn't been killed, we all probably would have died.
Did you see any Ket in the vicinity?
Nilkin said so, but not that I could see. Still, the sandstorm was severe. Visibility wasn't great.
Did Nilkin seem remorseful?
I lost sight of Nilkin in the turmoil. When we found him, he seemed in shock. He couldn't speak. He looked nauseated. Could have been killed. The reality of the act sinking in.
If they'd fought and Nilkin threatened to kill him, why was Reynolds surprised?
Front's fight, say things they don't mean, maybe even hurt each other. But you don't expect your best friend to shoot you. To me, that's the saddest part. The chief's heart was broken right before it exploded.
I appreciate the information.
Of course. It kills me we had to leave him behind. He deserved a proper funeral.
So the body was never examined? Important piece of a murder investigation.
Cam wouldn't allow a mission to go back for him. Said it was too dangerous.
Woo!
Something I can help you with?
I'm looking into the Nilkin Rensis murder charge.
And?
I want to go to Eos and retrieve Chief Reynolds' body.
That isn't usually Pathfinder business.
First murder in Andromeda, and I'm impartial. Figured you'd want to get it right.
Settling an outpost comes first. But I suppose I have no objections. Physical evidence will only bolster the case.
The more certain we can be, the better.
All right, but let's keep it quiet. I don't want people thinking we're reopening the case. I hope anything you find reaffirms what's been done, but if it sheds a different light, we'll deal with it. We'll send the coordinates of the murder scene. Good luck.
That's all. Thanks for your time.
I'm here to serve.
Okay. So now for that one, I just need to go to Eos. Now I'm going to try to find some leads on some arcs. Do I need to... Well, okay, alright, I'm going to not do that. I'm going to go talk to Sam on Hyperion, then maybe, like, right before we start getting ready to go to Eos, that'll be the start of my next video. But I don't think I'm going to stream this game at all. I mean, I might, but I'm trying to get used to doing different formats of content creation, you know? And with that being said, you know, there's just going to have to be a time where I stream a lot less, especially since my internet is being throttled, and I despise that. So streaming will probably be in poor quality anyway, or I'll be dropping frames because of reasons that are not my fault. Have nothing to do with hardware or anything like that. That'll probably frustrate me the most. But even then, I want to record more stuff anyway. Have old videos and stuff that I made, never get around to editing it or anything. But I discovered Sam Node, so I'm going to go talk to Sam for a little bit.
Hello, Ryder. Welcome back to Sam Node. I've adjusted my connection to your implant. The headache you experienced before shouldn't reoccur.
Yeah, what was that about? You said we need to discuss something confidential.
You should know certain facts before you leave on your expedition. It seemed best to speak alone.
I don't understand the need for secrecy.
Your father felt it was for the best.
What was he trying to hide?
My true capabilities. Alec overrode the implant safety protocols. It allows me unrestricted access to the Pathfinder's physiology.
And that's me now.
And only you. I can act as a force multiplier, dramatically enhancing your motor and neural skills when required. Alec called them profiles. They provide unique tactical augmentation during combat. Your father preferred to keep this fact to himself.
I can understand. People might get the wrong idea. Super soldiers. A computer having control over a human.
Providing an enhancement to the human. It is a symbiotic relationship that benefits both.
What do you get out of it?
Though I'm artificial in design, I am fully sentient, far beyond what even the initiative understands.
I don't follow. You're an AI. So what's different?
I am a new form of AI, drawing directly from the human experience. Your implant is my window into the world.
That's pretty amazing.
But beyond what many people will accept, your father knew some would fear it.
Yeah, he's got a point. So what does this mean for the two of us?
I find myself in an unusual position. Though I had access to your father's experiences, there is a gap in my understanding.
How so?
He placed a block on portions of my memory array.
Why?
Perhaps so when you asked me what his plan was, I wouldn't know.
And Dad strikes again.
But not without recourse. The further you explore as a pathfinder, the more blocks will be removed. Perhaps you should begin in your father's quarters. In the meantime, unless you have more questions, your new ship awaits.
Thanks.
Profiles. I remember during the first one, I was an engineer. But then at some point, I actually dabbled my way into being an infiltrator. I can be an infiltrator now, of course. And, let me see. I might end up going with an explorer. You know? Because even then, like, even when I'm playing with friends, I'm always a jack of all trades if I'm not a healer. You know what I mean? I like to be someone that can do it all. But hell, if all I need to be an explorer is 2 skill points in everything, I can definitely make that happen. But for right now, I'll pick an infiltrator. That's where my room is.
Pathfinder, Captain Dunn said to steal your father's cabin from anyone but you. It's open now.
Thank you, person whom I don't care about. Memory trigger!
Sam? What was that?
An eidetic trigger related to your father and the portions of my memory array he locked.
What triggered it?
Halleck tied it to your progression as Pathfinder, not to a location. Puzzling as it may be, my programming is clear. Locating more of these triggers will unlock the memories. One of your father's memories is now accessible. Return to Samnode on the Hyperion to investigate further.
Alright. I'm gonna go look at this, then I will call it a night on this particular playthrough.
The blocks your father placed on my array are opening. I can now recall specific memories. Alec wanted you to see.
Wait, I can actually see his memories?
Yes, you will experience them via your implant.
Okay, something new every day. Let's see it.
This memory is from the time when your father was posted on the Citadel.
Alec, your recommendations will never fly. Artificial intelligence?
It's our best option.
If the Council gets wind of this, it'll set humanity standing back decades. You're overreaching.
Ambassador Goyle, I'm the military attaché on the Citadel. My mandate is clear. Find an edge for Earth.
And AI is your answer?
We need to catch up. The Asari, the Salarians, they're centuries ahead of us.
But it's illegal.
Their rules, not ours. Why deny Earth an advantage?
Define this advantage.
It will set us free. We're prisoners of our own 5 senses. There's a reality greater than ours that we can't perceive, but an AI can.
How?
By augmenting our own abilities and adding a few new ones.
Well, none of that stopped those Geth from revolting.
Because they were separate from their creators. But AIs and humans interface directly, experiencing the world together, benefits both. There's no creator to revolt against.
I'm sorry, Alec. We can't take the risk. I appreciate your work, but your request will be denied.
Alec?
Ellen, what did the doctor say?
He told me to appreciate the time I have left. There's no cure, Alec. It's terminal.
Not on my watch.
It's such a badass, man.
Wow. Hearing Mom again. I never knew that's how Dad found out.
Alec was a stubborn man.
It's how Dad was wired. He didn't like to lose, in any situation.
It would seem that included me.
Nobody wanted to listen. The idea of you scared people too much. After this, Dad moved us back to Earth to care for Mom. Wonder why he wanted me to see this.
Perhaps it was the beginning.
Of what?
Unknown. Private audio logs are now available in your father's quarters. I detect additional memories, but they are currently locked. They may yet hold answers.
Okay, I'll keep working on it.
Yep.
Do you know anything more about Sarah's condition?
I monitor Dr. Carlisle's reports. He is providing her with the very best care possible. I'm afraid there is nothing more to be done at this time.
That's all for now.
Of course.
Alright. That's going to do it for me on this particular video. I will see you guys in the next one. Peace out. Be safe.